Good afternoon and welcome to our special Easter service. We have a really good Sunday school today. We've got some readings from some of the older boys and girls. Stephen Jackson from Aberdeen is going to tell the story today. And we've also got a very special audience with Alan. And watch out, before many of the boys and girls will feature in today's Sunday school. Our first chorus is Alive, Alive, My Saviour is Alive. Let's open in prayer. Our Father, we come before thee and thank thee again for thy Son this morning. We thank thee that on this Easter Sunday we've been able to gather in the hall to remember thy Son after over 1 year. Father, we think that Easter reminds us of an empty tomb, and thy word tells us that Christ died for our sins, that he was buried, and on that third day he arose. A great joy that is for every Christian. We thank thee again for opening thy word today. We pray a blessing upon it. Remember those in search of health today. We think of Alexandra's granny Jessie. We pray too for Elspeth, and we just ask for thy hand of blessing to be upon them as we return our thanks in the Saviour's name. Amen.
Then the soldiers of the government took Jesus into Praetorium and gathered the whole Roman cohort around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him. And after twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and a reed in his right hand. And they knelt down before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They spat on him and took the reed and began to beat him on the head.
Our next Easter hymn is O, To See the Dawn.
Oh, to see the dawn of the darkest day, Christ on the road to Calvary, tried by sinful men, torn and beaten. Yeah.
brought Jesus to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. Then they offered him wine mixed with myrrh, but he did not take it, and they crucified him, dividing up his clothes. They cast lots to see what each would get. It was 9 in the morning when they crucified him.
Our next hymn is "When I Survey the Wondrous Cross."
When I survey the wondrous cross on which the poor kind. thorns compose, so rich a crown.
Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his raiment and cast lots. And the people stood beholding, and the rulers also with them derided him, saying, He saved others, let him save himself. If he be Christ, the chosen of God. And the soldiers also mocked him, coming to him and offering vinegar, and saying, If thou be the King of the Jews, save thyself. And a subscription also was written over him in letters of Greek and Latin and Hebrews. This is the King of the Jews. Luke chapter 23, verse 34 to 38.
This week the teachers have been busy handing out Easter eggs. Let's take a look.
And it was about the sixth hour, and there was a darkness all over all the earth until the ninth hour. And the sun was darkened, and the veil of the temple was rent in the mist. And when Jesus had cried with a loud voice, he said, "Father, into thee hands I commend my spirit." And having said thus, he gave up the ghost.
Now it's time for the birthdays. Although none of the boys and girls actually have a birthday this week, there are a few birthdays over the Easter holidays. Firstly, we have Shelley Buchan and Roman King, both on the 12th of April. We then have Eden Stephen the following day, the 13th of April. Holly Hutton has her birthday on the 17th of April. And Pirelli Stephen has her birthday the day after the 18th of April. There's also one of the teachers has a special birthday this coming week. Esther Smith will be 30 on the 5th. And we wish all the boys and girls a very happy birthday.
Soldiers and break the legs of the first and of the other which was crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus and saw that he was dead already, they brake not his legs. But one of the soldiers with a spear pierced his side, and forthwith came there out blood and water. And he that saw it bare record, and his record is true, and he knoweth that he saith true, that he might believe.
Let's sing my favourite Easter hymn, "There is a green hill far away."
There is a green hill far away, outside a city wall, where the dear Lord was crucified, who died to save us all.
And after this, Joseph of Arimathea being a disciple of Jesus, but secretly, for fear of the Jews, besought Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave him leave. He came therefore and took the body of Jesus. And there came also Nicodemus, which at the first came to Jesus by night, and brought a mixture of myrrh and aloes, about 100 pound weight. Then they took the body of Jesus and wound it in linen cloths with the spices, as the manner of the Jews is to bury. Now in the place where he was crucified there was a garden, and in the garden there was a sepulchre, wherein was never man yet laid. There laid they Jesus therefore because of the Jews' preparation day, for the sepulchre was nigh at hand.
Time for the memory verse, and let's listen to last week's clips first.
The Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Luke chapter 19, verse 10.
The Son of Man has come to seek and save that which was lost.
The Son of Man is come to seek and what to save and what was not. Luke chapter 19 verse 10.
The Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. Luke chapter 19 verse 10.
The Son of Man came to seek and lost. And yet,
the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Luke chapter 19 verse 10.
The Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Luke chapter 19 verse 10.
Let's have a look at this week's memory verse. Let's say this week's verse all together. He is not here, for he is risen. Matthew chapter 28 and verse 6. Let's take away a few words. Let's take away a few more. Let's bring it back and say it once more all together. He is not here, for he is risen. Matthew chapter 28 and verse 6.
Sabbath was past, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Salmon had bought sweet spices that might come and anoint them.
And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came up to the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. And they said among themselves, "Who shall roll us away the stone from the door?" The sepulchre.
And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was great. And entering the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted.
And he said unto them, Be afraid, ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which crucified. He is risen, he is not here. Behold the place where he laid him.
Our next hymn is All Heaven Declares.
All
As I said earlier, I'm delighted that our speaker this week is Stephen Jackson from Aberdeen. So sit up and listen well to the story.
Hi guys, and thank you for joining us for the Easter message at for the Sunday School. My name's Steve, I'm English, so I'm going to try and speak really slowly and clearly so you can understand what I'm saying. And in front of me, I've got a big basket full of chocolate and eggs, and I'm sure that you've been enjoying some chocolate already. I remember when I was a kid eating a whole Mars bar Easter egg before breakfast on Easter Sunday, and I got really in trouble with my mum and dad for that one. I hope you haven't done that. What I've got is I've got a few eggs, and some of these open up, and I want to tell the Easter story through the use of some of these eggs. And the first egg that I'm going to open contains pretty much all the cash that's left in this house. Got a bunch of silver coins there. We're going to call them silver, but they're 5p pieces. And this is going to illustrate this part of the story about Jesus, who was with his friends, and one of his friends decided that he was going to betray Jesus. He knew that the soldiers and the Romans who were in Jerusalem wanted Jesus dead, as did a lot of the Jews in Israel at that time. And these soldiers, they offered this man Judas, who was supposed to be Jesus' friend, offered him 30 pieces of silver. Now, this isn't silver, and there aren't 30 pieces, but hopefully you'll understand, just to illustrate the point. Here's Judas, and he's staring at this money, and he thinks, should I betray Jesus? I know Jesus has done nothing wrong. I know he's the Son of God, but oh, that's so glistening and glittery, and look what I could buy with that money. Oh, and he decides to betray Jesus. And that was a terribly bad thing to do. He decided to betray Jesus, and he received these 30 pieces of silver. So he knew that Jesus was going to be in the garden with his friends praying. And he said to the Roman soldiers, he said, come with me, come with me. I know where Jesus is going to be. And it was nighttime, and Jesus finishes praying, and he looks up and he sees the torches coming through the trees of the garden, and he hears the stomp, stomp, stomp of the Roman soldiers' feet. And here they come, and they come up to him and they arrest him. And Jesus looks at Judas, and he knows that he's betrayed him, and he did it for those 30 pieces of silver. So Jesus is betrayed now, and he's not with his friends now. He's taken away, and he's put in a cell, and he's taken before the judge. And the Roman soldiers are beating him, and the judge basically is a whitewash. Jesus should have been found innocent. Jesus should have been let off without any charge. Has that ever happened to you, that you've been treated wrongly? Maybe someone's thought you did something wrong and you didn't. You know you didn't, and you're accused of it. Well, Jesus was accused of being the Son of God, and this was blasphemy. This meant they thought that Jesus was pretending to be the Son of God. But Jesus truly was the Son of God. He was sentenced to be crucified. And so I've got some little boys in my house who love Lego. So I've got a couple of Lego props here. And we've got a very basic, very simple Lego Lego cross to illustrate the point that Jesus was crucified. He was sentenced to death, and there on the cross of Calvary he gave his life for you and for me. And there on the cross God punished him for my sins. I want to ask you, have your sins been forgiven? You know, the lies that you've told, maybe you've stolen things, maybe you've been jealous of somebody. All of those are things the Bible calls sins, and they separate us from God. They have to be judged by God. God has to punish us for our sins. And when I think about the cross of Calvary, and I see Jesus dying on the cross, I see him dying for me. I see him dying in my place. And I see God in my mind's eye. I see God punishing Jesus for my sins. So there he is. He's been betrayed and he's been crucified. But you know, on the cross, I'm trying to find the next egg with the prop in here. On the cross of Calvary, there was crucified next to Jesus, there was crucified two thieves. And I've got a prop here, if I can find it. I'm shaking them around. Here it is. On the cross of Calvary, I knew it was in there somewhere, there was thieves. And maybe they'd done other bad things as well. They were crucified either side of Jesus. One on the left hand, one on the right. And they mocked Jesus. They were laughing at Jesus along with the other people who were passing by. And they were saying things like, oh, if you are who you say you are, if you're the Son of God, save yourself. Come down from the cross and save us as well. But this one, he thought, you know what? Actually, I know he is the Son of God, and I know that I'm guilty. And I like this thief because I see myself in this thief. Because this thief realized he was a sinner. He realized he had done wrong things. He realized that Jesus was the only one that could save him. And irrespective of the fact, it doesn't matter that he'd been laughing with his pal about Jesus, he turns to Jesus and he said, Lord, remember me. And he said, Lord, remember me when you come in your kingdom. And Jesus said, Jesus could have turned around and said, well, you shouldn't have been laughing at me. It serves you right. But he didn't. He turned around and he forgave him. He said, today you'll be with me in paradise. That's an amazing thing about the Saviour. He forgives anybody who comes to him, who is repentant, who is extremely sorry for their sins, and who is asking Jesus to save them, he will save. The Bible says he will save to the uttermost whoever comes to him. So there we have Jesus. He's been betrayed, he's been crucified, he's died for you, he's died for me. We've seen how he can forgive sins, and I've got one more egg to open. This one's the best one of all, it's golden. I'm going to move this aside one second. I've got another prop that my boys made to illustrate this point. So Jesus was on the cross of Calvary, and I'll just leave this here for one second. Jesus was on the cross and he died, and his friends came, and you'll forgive the representation of this, the Lego figures, I'm sure. His friends came and they took him. Can't fit my hands through the door, so I'm going to come around the side. They took him and they put him in a tomb. They buried him. This was his dead body. They buried him, and out they go through the door and away they go. They buried him there, and a stone was rolled across the door to stop anybody from entering. And some soldiers were put on guard to make sure no one entered. And forgive me using I think this is a ninja, and this is a police stormtrooper. So forgive me here, but here's the Roman soldiers, and they are guarding the entrance to the tomb where Jesus' body lay. And Jesus was in there for 3 days and three nights. Now it's time, I think, to open the best egg of them all. The other ones have been quite small, but this one's big because it needs to contain the good news, the good thing that's in here. This is very exciting. I hope you're ready for this one. And this egg, let's open it. I hope you can see that there. Oh, this one's a good one. Ah, there you go. Can you see it? Can you see it? Nothing there. Nothing there. Well, that's the point. See, the disciples came along to the tomb 3 days later, and they found the stone was rolled away, and the soldiers were lying down. The soldiers were rolled away, and look, come and look in the tomb. Come and look. Here they come. They're looking through the door, and in they go, and no one there. Jesus' body is not there. And just like we were excited about opening the golden egg here to see what was inside, and we saw there was nothing there, well, here's the disciples. They come to the tomb and there's nothing there. And maybe this is the best thing about the Easter message, that Jesus died for us, that he was buried, but that he rose again from the dead. You see, Jesus' body hadn't been taken. This stone was in the way, and the soldiers were guarding it. No, Jesus rose from the dead. His dead body took on life again. And this is the amazing thing about the Easter message. And I hope you remember this. Two key things, I guess, I hope you remember from this short message. That Jesus died for us and that he rose again. What does this mean? This means that death has been defeated. You know, every single one of us will die. But if we are a Christian, because Jesus has risen from the dead, we know this, that when he comes again, we will rise from the dead and we will be with him forever. So I hope you've understood and enjoyed the message. And I hope that you remember that Easter is not just about chocolate and sweeties and eggs and things like that. It's really about this, that Jesus, the Son of God, loved me. He gave himself for me by dying on the cross. He was punished for my sins, and that he was buried in a tomb and he rose again. I hope you enjoy the rest of your Easter, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you, Stephen. Let's sing, "Low in the grave he lay, Jesus my Saviour."
Oh. mighty triumph for his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose. My Savior, vainly they seal the dead, Jesus, my Lord. Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph for his foes. He rose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph on his foes. He rose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose, hallelujah, Christ arose.
But Mary stood without at the sepulchre weeping, and as she wept she stooped down and looked into the sepulchre, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. John chapter 20, verse 11 to 13.
Chapter 20, verse 14 to 16. And when she had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, Sir, if thou hast borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turned herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master.
Here are some more Easter egg pictures.
He is Lord.
Hi there and welcome to an audience with Alan. We did try to film this via Zoom earlier in the week and we had some technical difficulties, so we've done it in a different way just for this week. So tell me first of all what your name is, how old you are, and also if you have any brothers.
My name is Dotena Shadishabi. I'm 5 years old. I have one brother. His name is Zosi Shabi.
Can you tell me a wee bit about your school?
The name of my school is Little Genius. My teachers' names are Shisha, Vanilla, and Chicha Haas. My friend is Burko.
Now, I know you don't stay in Peterhead. So tell us a little bit about where you stay and also what the weather's like at this time of the year.
I stay in Slura, but
in Bodran. The weather today is a little bit hot.
You are very good at the memory verses and the books of the Bibles. So tell me, do you practice a lot to be as good as you are?
I know the song of the books of the Bible. Yes, I practice the verse.
Some of the recent Sunday school clips have shown the sea, and we saw 1 week about the fishermen, but I don't think where you stay is beside the sea, but do you manage to go to the seaside at all?
I don't manage to get to the seaside.
What do you like doing all day? What are your favourite things to do?
I like to write and colour and read.
What are you enjoying about the online Sunday school?
We learn verses and new songs, and we see things that we don't have here.
What's your favourite food or what's your favourite sweetie?
I like ice cream and pizza.
I really like pizza and ice cream myself, and we've some lovely ice cream shops over here in Scotland. What job would you like to do when you're bigger?
I want to be a pilot.
What a great job, and I hope that one of the first places that you will fly your plane to will be to Scotland to come and see the beautiful seaside here. What do you enjoy playing with all day?
I like to play with toys.
And finally, do you have a question that you would like to ask me?
Where do you work, Uncle Alan?
My job is to work in the job centre. And what we do in a job centre is we help people that are trying to find work or trying to find a job. And I've done that now for quite a long time. The one thing I meant to mention is I am loving your t-shirt. I don't know if you put that on specially because you were having the interview with myself today. I'd just like to say a huge thank you to Soti. Definitely, this is the audience with Alan that's taken place over the furthest distance. So thank you again. Thanks very much to Soti for his audience with Alan this week. and also to Soti and his family for both supporting us with the memory verses and learning the books of the Bible.
Our final hymn this week is God Sent His Son.
God sent his son, they called him.
Let's close with a word of prayer. Our Father, we come into thy presence and thank thee again for every boy and girl and household that's heard thy word today. We thank thee for the message from our brother Stephen. And we just pray that as boys and girls enjoy an Easter egg, that they'll be reminded of the true reason of Easter, that the stone has been rolled away and that the Saviour has arisen. Father, keep us safe over these coming weeks. We just look for thy hand of protection now as we return our thanks in his precious and worthy name. Amen. Thanks very much for watching Sunday School today, and a huge thank you to everyone who has helped in any way. We're going to have 2 weeks off for the holidays, so our next Sunday School will be on the 25th of April. I'm with no more audiences with Alan at the moment, so if you're still interested, please get in touch. Boys and girls, if you're at a loose end during the Easter holidays, here's a challenge for you. Watch the Sunday school again and count how many eggs in total you see. So there'll be Easter eggs, there may be some ornamental eggs, and also remember to count the eggs that Stephen takes out of the basket. Once you've got a total, send me a message and we'll have a prize for the person who gets the correct answer.